Next, we're going to cluster whiskies based on their flavor profiles. We'll do this using a clustering method from the scikit-learn machine learning module. The specific method we'll be using is called spectral co-clustering. One way to think about the spectral co-clustering method is to consider a list of words and a list of documents, which is the context in which the method was first introduced. We can represent the problem as a graph, where on the left we have words and on the right we have documents. Let's draw this. Words on the left. We have documents on the right. Here different circles correspond to different words. And we have our documents. I'm going to use squares for them. And we have lines connecting words to documents. So for example, in this particular document, these four words might appear. Of course, in practice, you have many more, but this is just a schematic of the basic idea. In the second document, we might have these words. And let me just fill in this picture. The goal is to find clusters that consist of sets of words and sets of documents that often go together. An extreme example would be books written in different languages. But we can also think about documents that deal with specific scientific fields, such as biology or physics. The term co-clustering refers to the idea that we simultaneously find both clusters of words and clusters of documents. In this example, the clusters might be this group over here, and the second cluster might be this group over here. So again, each cluster consists of both words and documents. The problem, as I've just presented it, is still too hard to tackle, but it turns out that we can find an approximate solution to the problem. We can first represent this graph as what is called an adjacency matrix, where the rows correspond to words and the columns correspond to documents. Any given element of this matrix represents the number of times a given word appears in the given document. We can then take this matrix, manipulate it in certain ways, and find an approximate solution to the stated clustering problem in terms of eigenvalues and eigenvectors of this modified matrix. We will not go into the details here, but the term spectral refers to the use of eigenvalues and eigenvectors of some matrix. And this is the meaning of the term spectral in spectral co-clustering. If you'd like to learn more about eigenvalues and eigenvectors, you can take any course or any textbook on matrix or linear algebra. We can think of the co-clustering technique as simultaneously clustering the rows and columns of a matrix, whatever they happen to represent. In this case, we'll be using the approach to find clusters of whiskies in our correlation matrix of whiskey flavors. This method effectively reorders the rows and columns of the correlation matrix so that we can see blocks corresponding to groups of whiskies more clearly. Since the whiskies in the dataset come from six different regions, we're going to ask the clustering algorithm to find six blocks. Let's first import the method, spectral co-clustering. We'll then call the co-clustering method. So we'll move it here. The first argument is going to be n clusters, which is the number of clusters we'd like to specify. In this case, we'll set that equal to 6. We'll also specify the random state to be equal to 0. This is a parameter that we don't have to care about too much at this point. We will capture this as our model. We've now created the model object. The second step is to fit the model using data from the core whiskey correlation matrix. Let's then look at the clusters that we have just uncovered. The output is an array with the following dimensions: number of row clusters times number of rows in the data matrix, the correlation matrix in this case. The entries of the array are either true or false. Each row in this array identifies a cluster, here ranging from 0 to 5, and each column identifies a row in the correlation matrix, here ranging from 0 to 85. If we sum over the columns of this array, we can find out how many observations belong to each cluster. Let's try it out. We'll use NumPySum. We'll take the model.rows, and we specify the axis. Remember, axis 0 is rows, axis equal to 1 is columns. The output tells us how many whiskies belong to cluster 0, cluster 1, cluster 2, and so on. For example, here, 19 whiskies belong to cluster number 2. If instead we sum over the rows, we can find out how many clusters belong to each observation. Because each observation belongs to just one of the six clusters, the answer should be 1 for all of them, but let's check that just to be sure. We can take the code we just had, and we just change axis to be equal to 0. And we can see that the output consists of 1s as expected. Let's look at the row labels in our model. How do we interpret the output here? Observation number 0 belongs to cluster number 5. Observation number 1 belongs to cluster number 2, and so on. All of the entries in the array have to be numbers between 0 and 5 because we specified 6 clusters.